singing at home.
La, la, la.
That's the fourth and final candle lit on our Advent crown, which can mean only one thing.
Yes, that Christmas Day is almost here, in less than 2 days to be precise.
But we're already in festive mood. The studio is decked out with trees and tinsel, the homemade cards we've received, and all the goodies and decorations we've made over the past few weeks. And everything is topped off by this fantastic 4-metre-high tree, which, after the programme, will go to the Blue Peter Old People Centre at Deptford.
There's no better place than BP to get in the Christmas mood, and today's programme is a real box of delights just waiting to be unwrapped.
Join me on a magical Christmas journey in search of the wise men's gifts of frankincense and myrrh.
And you'll be a fool to miss Stuart's festive fancies for trees that still need tinseling up.
And with carol singing round the tree led by the Salvation Army's Chalk Farm Band, it all adds up, pardon the pun, to a real cracker of a show. I'm allowing my joke on a Christmas show. I'm
sorry, Romana.
And thank you for all the cards and presents you've sent us. There are lots like the one I made a few weeks ago. In fact, they're actually much better. So I'm going to swiftly move on to these over here. This is being sent in by Helen Jones. And as you can see, there's Bonnie and Mabel, but also Romana, Katy, myself and Stuart in the bottom window. So well done to that, Helen, very well done. And over here, we have another fantastic card. It's been written in computer speak, Blue Peter, Happy Christmas, and it's from Peter Juggins. And it says over here, rather mysteriously, pull. So let's see what happens. Out comes Santa on his sleigh being led by Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, ready to deliver all those presents in just a couple of days' time.
Oh, no. It's coming to my house.
I can't wait.
It's come to mine first.
I know. I hope so. Now, this is one of the smallest cards we've received, and it's rather unusual because it's got an embroidered Christmas tree on the front. This is sent in by Ruth. Very lovely. And one of the biggest is from the Bird Patrol. And inside, there's even a Christmas game. Guess which bird is which. I'll be playing that later. Yes.
Now, will we have snow on Christmas Day?
Yes.
Possibly.
Yeah,
possibly.
Please.
And if we do, there might be a snowman inside. Now, this is by 4-year-old Anna Cousins, and she's decorated it with cotton wool. That's brilliant. They're nice and cosy for Christmas. Mabel, you like that one, don't you?
Yeah.
Yes, and she recently went to a bring and buy sale as well, so well done there. And it's great to get cards in the office because we're never quite sure what's going to pop out of them. And this one has a tree inside. It's a 3D Christmas tree, and it's from Lysander, and she's 9 years old, and she comes from Wiltshire. Thanks very much for that.
That's fantastic. Well, we've had another glittery card from Dan Oliver. It's also 3D. It says on the front, "We three kings of Orient are," and then you open it up, and there we have the three kings look with their gifts, bearing gifts and travelling far. That's fantastic. Thank you very much for that, Dan. And what about this rather festive BP card from Rachel and Claire from Woodford Green in Essex, the Blue Peter ship on the front. And you open it up, and there, in their 3D glory, are all of us presenters. There's Tim, there's the Advent crown, all four candles lit. Romana, Bonnie, Mabel, Stuart, and me stood there just in front of the totaliser. So thank you very, very much to Rachel and to Claire and to everyone who sent us a Christmas card.
Yes, indeed. And we've got some fantastic news about our leprosy appeal. On Friday, the totaliser was still flashing at 300,000. £1,000 stage. But thanks to everyone who's been holding bringing by sales, we can now light up our next stage, which is an amazing £400,000, which means that we're now just one stage away from our target of £500,000.
That's fantastic news, and from the looks of our map, we might get to the top of the totaliser very soon, because the whole country has gone bring and buy bonkers. So far, a tremendous 88,669 kits have been sent out, which is fab news.
Yes, indeed. Now, a big thank you to everyone who's had or is planning to have a bring and buy. Every penny you raise will go towards helping the thousands of people who suffer from the terrible disease leprosy in India and Brazil.
Que muita gente boa pôs o pé na profissão.
These children are relying on you to help rid this area of leprosy. Please hold a bring and buy sale and try and raise as much money as possible. Together, we can make a huge difference here.
Yay! We certainly can, and wouldn't it be a great start to 1997 if we reached a target of £500,000?
Absolutely. Keep up the good work, because we're not far away. Now, is your tree looking bare and boring?
Are you in need of some festive sparkle?
Hey, well, do not panic and be of cheer, because Yuletide Stuart is right here, antlers and all, with a nifty idea for any Christmas tree that's still in need of a few extra sparkly trimmings, tinsely Christmas flowers or stars that not only look gorgeous, but are quick and easy to make. Now, if you can lay your hands on some coloured fromage fray tubs just like this, here's how to transform them into Christmas flowers. Oh, and by the way, it's advisable to eat the fromage fray first, all right, and then wash and dry the tubs. Now, you'll see on them they have four corners, but what you want to do is take the narrow sides and then with a quite sharp pair of scissors, because it's quite tough, cut down on each side to the base. It's about the middle, there we are. Just straight down there, two, and four of those. So you'll end up with four individual pieces. Here we are. That's better, there we are. Now, these hard corners here, these need trimming off. Careful when you do this, because the plastic actually is quite tough, and when you've cut it, you've got quite a lot of sharp edges, so just trim that off like that, and then go round and shape it just there. There we are. And you can take a bit of time over that and get it into a nice coloured shape, and there you'll have your finished piece. Let's get rid of these little bits. It's Christmas, we want it nice and tidy. Now, what you want to do is you want about eight petals probably on this flower, so in order to do that, you just simply cut down again. It's very straightforward. Ideal last-minute Christmas make. You can make it in 5 or 10 minutes, and let's face it, if your mum and dad's Christmas tree is looking a little bit dull at the moment, then this will really brighten it up. There we are, eight of those. Now, for the real fun bit, we're going to transform this into something that's going to look like our flower simply by pushing the base down like that and carefully pressing around the outline. And hey presto, look, they all pop up. There we are, there's one there, and there's another one there, and one like that. That's all there is to it. Just pop them up like that and then shape them into what you want. Now, I'm going to put points on mine, because I'm going to make mine a festive star. But if you've got more time, you could probably shape them and spend a little bit more time and make a really beautiful flower. There we are. I'll do a couple of those. And when you've done all of them, it'll look, something like that. Now, it's time to decorate it. Now, you know how Tim always says you can never have enough glitter, but at Christmas, you can never, ever have enough tinsel. Now, I've got a couple of little gold tinsely bits here, which I'm going to decorate mine with. So, a little dab of glue in the middle there, a piece of tinsel, and just stick that on there. Now, the thing about these Christmas decorations is they always swing around. So, little stewy tip here, put a bit of glue on the back and put some tinsel there as well, because then it'll turn around and look just as beautiful on the other side. Now, to hang it, I've actually got some gold thread. You could use white cotton, a little bit of sticky tape there. Turn it over and just put the thread on. We'll put it there so you can see it, and we'll just put the tape there like so and wrap it around, and then the finished decoration is ready to hang on your tree. Now, where shall I hang it? Let's put it, tell you what, we'll just put it on there like that. There it is, looking gorgeous. Now, they look really exotic hung up, and if you want to vary the design, you can have a few tubs. You can make two layers maybe of petals glued on top of each other, just like this one there.
Or the little tubs also make very good bell shapes, and these are made in exactly the same way. You want to cut the tubs into 8 sections, but don't flatten out the shape. Cut the ends into points and decorate with sticky stars or glitter. And also you could maybe thread the hanging cord through the center and hang it up like that. There you go. Now, details of all this are, even as we speak, going up on CFAQ's page 525, so you can have a look after the program. And if, like me, you're wearing little antlers, you could perhaps decorate them there. There we are. Look at that. A festive reindeer. Marvellous. Oh.
Great antlers, Stuart, and a great idea for a last-minute decoration for your Christmas tree. In fact, I've got one here, so let's just put it on our tree. There you go. Fantastic. Now for another Blue Peter tradition, and one that I've always wanted to do. The special moment when we put the finishing touches to our Christmas nativity scene. More than anything else, it sets the scene for the festival ahead and all that it means. Now, some of the figures are already in place. There's the ox and the ass who were living in the stable in Bethlehem. And of course, there's Mary and Joseph. And now I'll add the other figures who came to see the baby. There were, of course, the shepherds who heard about the arrival of the baby by the angels. Sometime later, the wise men came from the east, following the star of Bethlehem. They arrived with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And finally, I'll add the most important figure. It is, of course, baby Jesus. And while I hope everyone will have a happy Christmas, it is worth remembering that for many people here in Britain and abroad, Christmas will not be a happy time. So let's hope the message of peace on earth will spread all over the world this Christmas.
Yeah, it's very important at this time of year not to forget the reason for Christmas. Well, now for a journey on the trail of the gifts brought by the wise men. Now, we all know what gold is, but what about frankincense and myrrh? Well, I travelled all the way to Africa in search of them to visit the ancient Christian highlands of Ethiopia. Ethiopia has one of the very oldest Christian churches in the world, dating back well over 1,500 years. This is St. Avile's Church in the heart of Ethiopia's capital, Addis Ababa. The air here is thick with the most beautiful smelling smoke, and the perfume that makes that amazing smell is frankincense. This rich natural fragrance lies at the heart of their ceremonies. It's a reminder of their belief in Ethiopia's connection with the baby Jesus. You can buy frankincense and myrrh all over Ethiopia for use in churches and homes. Down there is Makato, one of the biggest markets in the world. Utensils, and there's even a special area just selling incense. And here we are in the Menesh. Etan Aleish. I hope I've asked for 1 kilo of frankincense and 1 kilo of myrrh, but my Ethiopia is not that hot, so we shall see. There's an amazing smell at this store. It must be fantastic to work here.
Wow, you get lots for your kilo.
Seventeen Ethiopian birr, which is about £2. Not bad. For a kilo of myrrh and a kilo of frankincense, thank you very much.
To find out about the beliefs of Ethiopian Christians, I met Father Tesfer. He has a superb collection of Ethiopian religious manuscripts.
Now, we've got here a beautiful old picture of Joseph, Mary and Jesus and the wise men coming to see Jesus. Who do you think the wise men were?
The wise man, the first man, look just like the pictures. The king of Ethiopia.
That's the first one.
The first one. And the second, the king of Upper and Lower Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
And the third one, the king of Yemen.
So three kings.
Three kings, they're two brothers.
Here they are on the end here. And they've got with them gifts, gold, frankincense and myrrh. Your Ethiopian cross looks a bit like a star. Is that why it's that shape?
Yeah, just like the star of shape that we have. We don't forget still that we remember the star that's a guide to the Christ.
We've also got the star here with the long tail that points to Jesus. That's how they knew he was there. How long would it take to get from Ethiopia to Bethlehem?
2 years.
I was on a journey myself, but hopefully it wouldn't take as long as 2 years. I'm in search of where frankincense and myrrh actually come from, the Ethiopian trees that hold this precious gift. And to find them, we have to travel down into the hot lowlands. Hidden in the countryside, trees hold the secret of frankincense and myrrh. My destination was the Awash National Park, home of myrrh trees and wildlife.
There's a tortoise on the road. I've heard about a zebra crossing, but I mean, that's ridiculous.
Running through the park is the Awash River, swollen by the annual rains. Right here above the Awash River Falls is the answer to my quest. Komifore, the myrrh tree. Now, the incense is actually made from the tree's resin. That's the gummy stuff the tree produces to try to heal any cuts in its trunk. So to get the myrrh out of the tree, all you have to do is make a small cut. An expert on myrrh trees is Amanda Cabo from Addis Ababa University. How do I cut the tree, Amanda?
You have to make a small circle.
Okay. Like this?
Yeah.
How long till the resin starts coming? Oh, I can see it.
Immediately gone.
It's coming immediately. Yeah, can we collect it now?
You have to come back tomorrow.
Oh, till there's more resin.
Yeah.
Okay, please, lots of resin tree. You've got to be patient with this. Lots. Oh, it's so peaceful now. The heat's finally gone out of the sun. I never thought it would. And I've found some myrrh, amazingly. I wonder if that makes me a wise woman. Nah, I doubt it. Aman, I've waited patiently for 18 hours. Let's have a look. We've got lots of myrrh. Look at that. It was worth waiting.
Yeah.
I knew this good old tree wouldn't let us down. Can I pick that off now?
Yeah.
Look at that. It's myrrh. It's gone much harder and darker than last night. Doesn't smell very much,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it smells, but you have to burn it.
Oh, you've got to burn it to get the real smell off. I'm so excited. I've come all the way to Ethiopia in search of myrrh, and this tree didn't let me down. Like myrrh, frankincense also comes from the resin of Ethiopian trees. They're both much loved by Ethiopians, used not just in their churches, but in their houses too. This is Asta and Solomon's home. Like all Ethiopians, they celebrate any family gatherings with a traditional coffee ceremony. The ceremony is full of carefully observed rituals. Beans are roasted and ground to make a perfect cup of strong, sweet coffee. And no ceremony is complete without the smell of frankincense and myrrh, burnt as a reminder of the life of Jesus. Ethiopia is a remarkable country. It's amazing to think that nearly 2,000 years ago, wise men may have travelled all the way from here to Bethlehem, bearing gifts of incense taken from Ethiopian trees for the baby Jesus.
Wow, I just didn't know that myrrh came from trees.
I know, it's amazing. You just tap it and out it comes.
Wow.
After one night.
Shame gold doesn't.
Now it's present time for Bonnie, Mabel, Carrie and Oakie. And the bringer of their gifts is our very own wise person, Mabel. Claire. Coming in from the
Claire.
Tree.
I'm Claire, actually, today welcome. I'm more like Santa's helper, Yay. Bearing gifts for the nation's favourite pets. We have a present for Oakie.
Oh, Oakie.
Can you open it for
her? Shall I open it for her?
Yes, please.
Want the carries?
Take carries.
Yeah.
So I'll rip it open.
Oh, Oakie, look!
Oakie, look what you've got. You've actually got some catnip
cat nibbles, seafood flavour, your favourite, and also some crunch and a little few balls. And look, a mouse at the top. I think Mabel's
interested. Oh, Mabel.
And you've got, Carrie, you've got the same. You've got little snack treats there, chicken flavour for you.
You're going to love like this.
You're going to enjoy
it's like
that, aren't you?
It's a little Christmas dinner. Cat Christmas dinner.
Bonnie's being so good. She deserves a present, doesn't she? That's for Bonnie.
Okay, let's open Bonnie.
Oh, Bonnie.
Look.
Bonnie.
Hey, look. Now, you're going to like this, Bonnie. A little car for you to play with, all right? And, because we know you're getting on a bit now, Bonnie, this coat is for you. So
lovely. Oh, Bonnie.
Matches my slippers.
Bonnie.
Yeah, that's going to keep you warm in the winter, isn't it?
Well, Claire, that's the cats and Bonnie, but aren't you forgetting someone?
I always want to have a gift for Mabel.
Please, that's not yours.
How's she been doing in the training classes?
Oh, she's been very, very good.
All right, then. Let's have a look under this Father Christmas. Mabel was here.
Oh, Mabel, look.
Look, it's Mabel. Look. What is it? What is it? Look, Mabes, come here.
Mabel, come here quickly.
Mabel, look. Oh, look.
Oh!
Look, wait, there's more.
Excellent.
Mr. Raggy, look, a new one.
Oh, wow, fantastic.
Hours and hours of fun. Well, if you can hardly believe that Christmas Day is nearly here, you will now, because it's time for carols around our tree. And we hope you're going to join in too.
Yes, we're going to sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing. And you'll be pleased to hear that we've got lots of help. Singers from five schools, all following primary from Wandsworth, Burstow Primary from Hawley, Linden Bridge from Worcester Park, Ringsfield Primary from Suffolk, and Warlingham School from Surrey, together with members of the BBC Symphony Chorus. And I can hear them now. They're being led in by our friends, the Chalk Farm Band of the Salvation Army.
In a moment, but before we go, we'd like to wish everyone a very happy Christmas.
We won't be here on Wednesday, Christmas Day, but don't forget to watch this Friday and next Wednesday, when we'll be showing all the best bits and magic moments from this year's Blue Peter.
And good luck if you're running a ring and buy sale over the holidays, or if you're going to one. Every penny raised will help us get nearer to the top of the totaliser and nearer to curing the thousands of people who suffer from leprosy.
From everyone on Blue Peter, from all of us in the studio, we wish you a very happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas!
All together now.
Happy Christmas!
Boxing Day on BBC One.